10 News presents Democracy 2012. Your voice, your vote.
Well, with the general election just weeks away, 10 News and the E.W. Scripps Company are dedicated to providing the information that you need to make those informed decisions. Tonight, we're talking about Prop 33, the 2012 Automobile Insurance Discount Act. And Rachel Hooper is here on behalf of Yes on Prop 33. Carmen Balbor is representing No on Prop 33, their campaign. So let me start with you, Rachel. Prop 33, one of the ads claims that if it's passed, Prop 33 will ensure that more drivers are insured. Is that true?
Yeah, it is true. In fact, so Prop 33 will save consumers money. Basically, consumers, if Prop 33 passes, will be able to switch insurance companies and keep their continuous coverage discount. Currently, you're allowed a continuous coverage discount for being responsible and maintaining car insurance, but only with your current carrier. If Prop 33 passes, you're allowed to shop that discount with any insurance carrier you choose. And we really believe it's all about competition, making insurance companies compete harder for our business, insuring more folks, and lowering rates.
Okay, Carmen, those opposed to Prop 33 say it would actually lead to more uninsured drivers. Why do you say that?
Because Proposition 33 would raise rates on drivers who had a break in their insurance coverage for any reason, even if they weren't driving, even if they were taking public transportation, even if they didn't have a car. We've got an insurance industry initiative here, one measure sponsored by one insurance industry billionaire who's given $8.4 million to give his insurance company the ability to charge you more if you had a break in your coverage. This isn't about discounts. This is about giving an insurance company an ability to raise rates on customers they just don't want. If you raise rates on uninsured drivers, it's going to make it harder to get into the insurance market. That not only increases the rate of uninsured drivers, but increases the rate of uninsured motorist premiums for every driver who's already insured.
So to let our viewers know what Carmen is talking about, is it true that 99% of the funding for this proposition is from George Joseph, chairman of Mercury Insurance?
Yeah, he is funding it out of his personal funds because he believes in competition and opening up the market. And we really believe, again, that it's such a good idea. Carmen mentions the surcharge issue, and the deal is current law already surcharges folks. If you lapse your payment for one day for any reason currently, or your car insurance coverage, you lose that discount. And we just don't think that's fair. It's such a good idea. That's why military groups such as USAA Insurance, the GI Forum, American Legion, and Vietnam Veterans of America all come out in support of Prop 33.
Carmen, you're shaking your head.
Well, that's because what Rachel said about current discounts is absolutely false. Currently, under California law, it's been the law for 24 years that bans insurance companies from charging you more just because you didn't have prior insurance. That's because insurance companies were refusing to sell coverage in the inner city to lower income people, to minorities. California voters passed a law 24 years ago saying that kind of discrimination should be illegal. Prop 33 rolls back the clock, overturns those consumer protections. The real question you have to ask here is follow the money. When was the last time an insurance industry billionaire spent $8 million to give people discounts? The answer is never.
If I might respond, you know, so from 1996 to 2002, actually, this portable persistency discount that we're talking about that, yes, on Prop 33 would allow was enacted here in California, and the number of uninsured motorists dropped in half. And so we just think it's really powerful. Again, it's all about competition and making insurance companies work harder for our business. The bottom line is consumers deserve to switch insurance companies and keep their longevity discount. It just makes sense for California.
Let me ask you this. This proposition is very similar to Prop 17, which Californians voted down just 2 years ago. Why bring something back so similar, or what's different about it?
So there are significant differences, and I think a lot of people are making that assumption that they're similar, but no, significant differences. And the main one that we'd like to suggest here is military families. All active military families are deemed continuously covered or qualify for this continuous coverage discount. And that's why these military groups, like I mentioned before, the American Legion, the GI Forum, USAA Insurance, all came on board. We have other endorsers that are a huge deal. Public safety throughout California, CDF firefighters, CAHP, the Association of Highway Patrol, all endorse Prop 33. And lastly, the Greenlining Institute, which was founded to fight redlining and really serves as a voice for underserved and minority communities, has come on board. They oppose Prop 17, but because Prop 33 is so different, they support it.
Let me interrupt you here. Carmen, I'm going to give you about 20 seconds for the last word here.
Well, I'll tell you that every major editorial board in the state, including the San Diego Union Tribune and the North County Times, have urged voters to vote no on Prop 33 because of exactly what you said, that it's a redux of the same ballot initiative that consumers rejected 2 years ago because it would raise insurance rates on drivers who don't currently have coverage, even if they were following the law and didn't have a car or weren't driving. It's not fair. That's why we urge voters no on
Ladies, 33. Thank you for your time. We hope that you have been informed with this. The general election, don't forget, is November the 6th.